If I told you that you can use nearly any CSS selector to get an element in JavaScript, would you believe me? Well, you should, because this is possible thanks to querySelector and querySelectorAll. So here I have the index.html. I've got a few elements, okay, that I'm going to get with querySelector and querySelectorAll, okay? So let's go down to the script down here. So the amazing thing about querySelectors is that you can use nearly any CSS selector apart from pseudo selectors, okay? As stated in the documentation, the use of pseudo elements in selectors is permitted, but they won't match any element, so it doesn't make sense to use them. These methods raise a syntax exception if the selector is not valid and return null if no matches are found, okay? So let's start with a really simple one. So const first element is equal to document.querySelector, and I'm going to use the selector, the ID selector first, then let's get the input. More complex one, document.querySelector, div, input, type equal text. So only the input which is child of a div with type text is returned. And then at the end, my class element, document.querySelector, and then the class selector, my class by that. Okay, perfect. If we log them all like this, so first element, my input, my class element, we can get up here first input type. So basically, you are getting this one, you're getting this one, and you're getting this one again. So why this one? You are actually targeting my class, and there are more than one, my class. But as you're using querySelector, only the first one that matches the selector is returned, okay? So in this case, only the first one. But if you want to get all of the elements with a certain class, for example, you can do something like my class elements equal to document.querySelectorAll in this case, and then my class. And if we print that to the console, you get my class elements. You get this node list with all the elements with my class. So this is basically an array. You can loop through that and do whatever you want with its element, okay? One thing that I haven't mentioned is that you can use two or more selectors separated by a comma. So for example, if we do something like my element equal document dot query selector, something like that, then here, third, and then fourth, okay? And we print that, I forgot, here, okay? And if we print that, my element, like this, you can see that you're getting the third. Okay, why? Because in this case, you're using a sort of fallback value. Okay, if the first value doesn't match any element, then the second one is used. Of course, this is because we're using querySelector. Okay, so just one element can be returned. If we were to remove third from here and save that, you can see that you get fourth. Okay, so this is fourth is sort of a fallback value. If the third is not there, you're getting the fourth. Okay, perfect. On the other hand, when you're getting more than one element, so in this case, const my elements, querySelectorAll in this case, if you do something like my class, comma, my class 2, you're not only getting the elements with my class, but also the elements with my class 2. So if we print that, my elements, like that, you can see that you've got my class, my class, my class 2, my class 2. So all the elements are included, not just the first value, but also this value. So if here you had another class, you get also the elements with that class as well in the same node list. Okay, really, really easy and useful. So far we've used this method directly on the whole document, and you're looking for a match on the whole document. However, this could be used on any element, and only the elements that match a specific selector that are also children of that element, of the element on which the method is called, are returned. Okay, so const base element equal to document.querySelector, and we get parent like that. Then down here, we do something like child, base element, not document anymore, selector, my class. If we log child, we get the child, the ID child, which is the element in here, okay? So why is that? Basically, you've got this, 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 and this. These have all the my class class, okay? But only those two are children of this element, which is a base element in this case. And as we're using, of course, querySelector, only the first one is returned. If we were using querySelectorAll, these two would be returned. So now go and watch the other video you see on the screen, because if you're still here watching, I'm sure you're going to enjoy that one as well.